Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Vedanti. My topic for today is the sex of the dead, that is the sex determination of the dead deceased. So can I proceed?
Yeah, please go ahead. We'll show your presentation once we get.
Yes, sir. What is sex determination and why is it important? Sex determination is, of course, the differentiation between the male, female and the other sexes, which are based upon the genetic factors. Sex determination, of course, plays a vital role in identifying the identity of a dead deceased whose identity is not revealed. In cases where there is mass destruction. Okay, sir.
Yeah, please go ahead. You go ahead.
In cases wherever there is mass destruction, natural calamities. Next slide. Mass destruction. Yes, this one. In cases where there is mass destruction, a chemical explosion, transportation accident, cases of a missing person reports, or any sexual assault. In all these cases above mentioned, there might be some cases where there is destruction of the external features or the soft tissue organs. And there might also be some cases where there is only a few skeletal remains of the disease available for the forensic investigations. In such cases, sex determination becomes a priority of the forensic investigations. My aim of my paper today is to discuss about the various methods by the means of, the aim of my presentation today is to discuss about the sex determination by the molecular analysis and various methods for the extraction of the DNA. So the sex determination analysis is basically divided into two types, morphological analysis and molecular analysis. Morphological analysis basically is done both on hard tissue as well as on soft tissues. On hard tissues, it is done by odontometric analysis or orthometric analysis. On soft tissues, it is done by chelioscopy or rugoscopy. The second is the molecular analysis in which, please go back, in molecular analysis where the analysis is done by the sex determination. Why do we prefer molecular analysis over morphological analysis? Of course, because morphological analysis might vary with time and external factors. So in such situations, the best suited conditions for the best suited conditions is molecular analysis of DNA. DNA analysis have served as a gold standard in forensics, and it has a high percent of accuracy rate. Different types of DNA which are used for the DNA analysis are nuclear DNA and mitochondrial DNA. Nuclear DNA is highly used for this process, whereas mitochondrial DNA is used to find the maternal lineage of the disease. From where to extract the DNA? The extraction of the DNA is either done by two methods. One is by cryogenic grinding, in which it involves cooling the whole tooth at a very low temperature and then grinding it into small particles to extract the DNA. The second less destructive method used for DNA isolation involves opening the root and then scraping off the pulp area with the help of a notched medical needle and then using that pulp for the DNA analysis. The sources from where the DNA can be extracted are as follows. In cases where there is a missing person case or if there is an unidentified suspect, in such cases, if that patient is having any dental prosthesis, then the saliva from the dental prosthesis can be used for the identification. And also the same goes for the epithelial cells, which are present on the toothbrush and of dental prosthesis. If in the history, the patient has gone under any extraction and if that extracted tooth is stored, then an extracted tooth can be used also as a means of an identification. The other oral tissues which are used for identification is dentine, pulp, and cementum. Next. What to look in for males and females? In males, you have to look in for F bodies, whereas in females, you have to look in for bar bodies. And with these F bodies are present on the SRY gene on Y chromosome, whereas the bar bodies are present on X chromosome. In males, for staining of the F bodies, we use specifically a fluorescent dye or quinacridone, which binds strongly to the Y chromosome. It can be seen under UV light in a microscope. Whereas for staining of the bar bodies, we use a nuclear dyes like hematoxylin stain, which stains the dense mass of chromatin on nuclei in females, whereas it's light in males. Both of these bodies can be extracted from the pulp. As you can see in the image on the left hand side, there is the fluorescent dye, which is F bodies is stained in fluorescent dye, whereas it's absent in females. On the picture next to it, you can see in female the bar body is stained very dark as compared to that in males. Next. which gene to prefer for sex determination. The most widely used gene for this process is amelogenin gene, where this gene is involved for amelogenesis and in the development of enamel. In females, there are two AmelX genes present, which helps in the identification of the females, wherein in males, there is one AmelX and one AmelY gene present, which helps in the identification of males. Other than that, there are two genes there are which helps in the identification of males. One is SRY gene and the other one is DYS14 gene. The SRY gene helps in the formation of the testes, whereas the DYS14 gene helps in the plays a role in spermatogenesis. Next. How to go about the technique. As we know, PCR is the most widely used technique and it's most advanced technique. For this, we need to collect the sample, decontaminate it to about 0.9% of isotonic saline solution for around 15 minutes, and then wash it with water to clear all the external contaminants. This should be performed under aseptic conditions. Then the pulp is expirated by making an endodontic cavity and accessing the pulp chamber, and then removing the pulp and then transferring it to a phosphate buffer saline solution at minus 20 degrees Celsius. Then the detection of the sex determined gene is done. And then at the end, the results are cross-matched. Next. And next, the DNA extraction. After the sample is completely thawed of the frozen sample, the storage, it is removed from the storage, that is from the buffer saline, and then it is transferred into an Eppendorf tube, and the further procedures are performed. Then this Eppendorf tube is transferred to the polymerase chain reaction technique machine, and then the gene over there are amplified. Genes like SRY, amelogen, and DYS14 genes are amplified. Then the PCR products which are obtained are checked via gel electrophoresis on a 2% agarose agar gel solution with ethidium bromide and visualized by using the UV gel documentation system. Next. Hence, I would like to conclude my presentation by saying that the sex determination gene, the sex determination by the molecular analysis usually traces the genes which are present on the buccal mucosa and buccal mucosa and all the other parts of the buccal mucosa, pulp and dentine, and they show the presence of the gene like amelogenin DYS14 gene, which helps in the process of identification. Thank you.